It's time for Ask the Doctors, the segment where we get to answer all of your burning questions. But for now, we're only going skin deep because we're answering all of your skin-related questions with our dermatologist, Dr. Sonia Batra. Y'all ready? The first question comes from YouTube, and our viewer writes, I'm seeing photos of skin gritting to remove blackheads over social media, but does this really work? And is it safe for your skin? Skin gritting. Everyone's wondering what that is. So am I. What is skin gritting?
So what this is from an online message board of people who love skincare, and it was specifically about how to remove blackheads. And the idea is first you take a facial oil and you massage it into your face for a couple minutes, then you follow it with a clay mask, and then you again go ahead and massage your face again with facial oil. And there are these photos on this line, and it's really actually gone quite viral because there are these little black spicules on the backs of people's hands. Elsewhere, showing all of these quote-unquote blackheads that they've extracted from their face doing this skin gritting technique.
Okay.
Do you think it works?
So here's the thing, blackheads don't look like this.
No.
So if you've ever squeezed out a blackhead, it's black at the very top, but that's because that's what's exposed to air, that's what's oxidized. So the base, that sebum, is usually white.
Those don't look like blackheads.
Those are kind of dark colored all the way through. So I suspect they may be some combination of the clay and dirt or the clay and sebum, but—
Fake news.
Fake news. So I think about this, I don't think it's gonna harm anyone as long as you're not too abrasive, you're not rupturing capillaries. You're not going to injure your skin necessarily doing this. I think if you are really prone to blackheads, you should be revisiting why you're putting a whole bunch of oil on your face over and over. But I think that though these might not be blackheads, if you really do want to remove your blackheads, an alternate route would be to steam your face. Just gently, don't burn yourself so that you soften up that sebum.
I think steam is the best.
Yeah.
If you want to extract, clean your pores, including the blackhead steams.
Yeah. And then you could do your clay mask after that, or
gentle pressure.
Professionally done.
Yes, gentle pressure and exfoliate and then put some sort of astringent on, then you feel good.
Feel good.
Let's hit up our next question. It's an email from one of our viewers named Nicole who writes, can your skin become addicted to anti-itch creams? I read a story about how one woman's entire body turned red and flaky after discontinuing use of her skin creams.
So actually, this is the photos from that story that went viral. And this poor, unfortunate woman had been using steroid prescription creams for 25 years for her eczema. She'd also been taking oral medications. And her viral story is that when she stopped using these creams, she went through an incredibly protracted and difficult steroid withdrawal process. This is also called red skin syndrome or topical steroid addiction. So it has a couple names, but the idea is that steroids are not meant to be used continuously. So remember, when we talk about eczema, we're always talking about barrier deficiencies of the skin. That means that your skin isn't sealed, it's not keeping the outside world out. So when it becomes inflamed, you can use a steroid once or twice a day for a week or two, but you should never ever be in a situation where you're using it constantly, because it is true, your skin will become tolerant to it, it will become used to it, and it will need it. And so when you just abruptly stop it, like this poor woman did after 25 years, your skin will go through a withdrawal. It'll be red, miserable, cracked, and fissured. I think it really goes back to the point that for people with eczema, their mainstays should be scent-free, dye-free detergent, cleanser, moisturizer, really keeping that skin sealed and not constantly using something like
this. So if your doctor is recommending this, you should maybe get a second opinion if they're saying they want to keep you on steroid creams for year after year.
Absolutely, because we know that indefinitely, regardless of the dependency that comes up, it's going to thin your skin, it's going to make the skin more vascular and red looking. I mean, there are long-term risks to steroids in general, but I think that a week or two in a pinch, they're great medicines to use as needed, but not something for maintenance.
And I know a lot of great dermatologists out there, but I like ours the best. Thanks.
Yeah.